Hi there. Hope you have a fantastic day today. This lesson, we will work on one of the past numeracy test paper. Of course, there is a PDF versions on the description below for you to download so you can work with me. Otherwise, let's go straight into it. This is a non-calculator part, so we have to do with our calculator. So first one, a shop sells balloons in a bag of five. For a party, 20 balloons were needed. How many bags of balloon are needed? So first of all, we need to write down. So we know that one bag, let's say this is bag, okay, is equal to 5 balloons. So this is 5. And in a party, we need 20 of them. So this is 20. So how many bags we need? So from here to here, 5 to 20, so we go 5, 10, 15, 20. So we need 4, okay, to times 4 to get 20. So 5 times 4 is 20. So therefore, on this side, we need to times by 4 as well. So 1 times 4 is 4. So therefore, we need 4 bags. That's the answer. So there you go. Second one. Joe's measure a distance to be 5 meters and 12 centimeters. Which of these shows how Joe can write this measurement in meters? So first of all, we need to know that 1 meter is 100 centimeters. Now, if we cannot remember what we can do, we can write kilometers first. That's the largest unit, followed by meters, centimeters, and millimeters. So now from here to here, we start with 1,000. So we times by 10 less each time. So we times 100. And from here to here, we times 10. But now we need to convert centimeters in meters because this is 5 meters already. So the measurement at the moment is 5 meters and 12 centimeters. So the question is asking us to convert this into meters. So now I just convert that into meters. So from here to here, I divide by 10. And from here to here, I divide by 100. So therefore, 12 divided by 100, which is, so no decimal point, that means the decimal point right at the back here. So when we divide by 100, the number gets smaller. So we move to this side, we cancel. We divide by another 0, cancel. So 0.12. So that is 0.12. So that is meters. So therefore we have 5 meters and 0.12 meters. So 5.12 meters. So therefore the answer should be this answer here. So there you go. Next one. A bag contains 15 beds that are either red or yellow. The probability of randomly removing a red bed is 20%. So we know that this is 20%. I can just write this down. Red is 20%. What is the probability of random removing a yellow bed? So we know that altogether we need to add up to 100%. So this is already 20%. So therefore the yellow one should be 80% because the improbability, so we need to add up to 100. So that become 100%. So we do just go 100 minus 20, so should give us 80%. So we already have percentage symbol here, so what we need to do is we just need to write 80. So there you go. Next one. Amelia wants to find the number of people who are enrolled in either a music class or a drama class, but not both. So first of all, so we can just write here music and drama class. So she only wants either enrolled music class or drama, but not both. Okay, so this intersection here is for both. So what we do, we just highlight this. So this is music only, this is drama only. So we can see which one is this. So therefore it should be this one here because this is music only and this is drama only. So that should be the answer. Next one. Point P, it translates 4 units down. So what that means, it just go directly down 4 units. So with that 3 there, we move down 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is P here. So therefore, this P now is 2, negative 1. So therefore, the answer should be A here. So this one, so 2, negative 1. So there you go. Question 5. The heights in centimeters of children on tennis team are as follows. So we have 119, 122, and so on. Select the dot plots that correctly display the data. So first of all, we have 119. So 119, so we just go 119 here. We have 119, and the first one doesn't have 119. So this is wrong. And the next score is 122. So we'll have a look at this, 122, 122. So that is correct so far. And we have 119. So 119 is here, and here doesn't have 119. So therefore, we cross this here. So the answer should be this one here. So there you go. Question 7. Beth made a ramp to replace a set of steps that were 0.5 meters high. The ratio of the horizontal length of the ramp to its height is 12 to 1. So that is 12 to 1. So therefore, what is the horizontal length of the ramp? So we know that the height is 0.5. So this is 0.5, that's a height. So we know that this is the length and this is the height. So therefore, from here to here, we times by a half, or times by 0.5 if you like. So we can times a half easier. So from here to here, we also need to times a half. So therefore, a half of 12 is 6. So the answer should be 6 meters for the horizontal length of the ramp. So therefore, this should be the answer. So there you go. Question 8. Tom joins a gym, has a monthly fees of $56. Member pays extra $6 per session if they want to work with a gym trainer. Which expression represents Tom's monthly gym bill if he works with a trainer for X sessions during the month? So first of all, so we know that Tom has to pay $56 first of all, regardless whether he's one a gym trainer or not, okay? So therefore, each sessions, he need to pay another $6. So if he's going for one sessions, so that would be at six on top. If it two, it will be two times six and X sessions. So therefore, six times X. So that is 6X. So that should be the expressions. So which one it is? So that is, so there you go. This is 56 plus X. Number 9. Grace throws a ball from a height of 2 meters. The maximum height of a ball after it is thrown is 4 meters. The ball lands on the ground about 2 seconds after it is thrown. So first of all, we know that the initial, at the beginning, the ball is start from 2 meters height. So that is the height of 2 meters to start with. So therefore, this graph here start with 2 meters. This graph start with 2 meters, and this is start at 0. So start 4 meters high. So this is wrong, and this is wrong straight away. And then we need to find the maximum height, and we know that the maximum height of the ball is 4 meters. So this is 4 meters here, the maximum height, and this is wrong because the maximum height is 2 meters. So therefore, the answer is this one here. Because it's had a maximum height of 4 and then it start at 2 meters high. Number 10. Riley is building a tabletop in the shape of a parallelogram. What is the perimeter of the tabletop? So perimeter is we need to add the length around the shapes, okay? So we have 110 and we have another 110 because opposite sides of parallelograms are equal. So we add 110. So that should give me 220. And then we have 90, and we have another 90. So 2 lots of 90 is 180. So we just add 180. So we add them up. So that give me 0. Add this. Give me 10. Carry 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 plus 1 is 4. So that should be 400 centimeters. So this is the answer. There you go. Question 11. The diameter of a red blood cell is 0.0076 millimeters. Which of these shows the diameter in scientific notations? So for scientific notations, we need to have a non-zero digit in front of the decimal point. So to do this, so what we do, let me just write this down. So we have 0.0076. So that should be equal non-zero digit in front of the decimal point. And then we times 10 to the power of a number, right? So we just move the decimal point 1, 2, 3. So 3 decimal places to the right hand side. So 7.6. So times 10 to the 3. But then because we move the decimal point to the right, so therefore it should be negative. Otherwise, you can just remember when the numbers are less than 1, so the index here should be negative. Keep that in mind. So the answer should be 7.6 times 10 to the negative 3. So this should be the answer. So there you go. So there is a link on the description below about scientific notations just for you to practice if needed. Okay? Question 12. Jen and David had identical chocolate bars. David ate 7/8 of his chocolate bar. David ate 7/8 of his chocolate bar. Jen ate more of her chocolate bar than David. What fractions of her chocolate bar could Jen have eaten? So first of all, we need to know that. So we know David ate 7/8 of his chocolate bar. So whereas Jen ate more than that. So we need to find out which of the fractions is greater than 7/8. So first of all, we can eliminate some of them out. So we know that 8 over 10 is actually less than 7 over 8. And 7 over 9 is less than 7 over 8. So therefore, we have either this or this number so to work with. So what we do, you can either make it into the same common denominator with 7/8, or we can just make numerator the same, or we can just divide the fractions, so then we can see the decimal point and we can see which one is greater. So let me just make the numerator the same. So 7/8, and let me just compare 7/8 and 8/8. So if 8/8 is greater than 7/8, that's the answer. If not, it should be this answer. Okay, we've got two options to work with. So first of all, to make 8/9, same as 8/7. So let's make the numerator the same. So I times this by 8, I times this by 8. So 7 times 8 will give me 56. So write 56 over, so 8 times 8 is 64. And then 8/9, so to make the numerator the same, so we times this by 7. So 56, and we times this by 7. So 9 times 7 is 63. So you can see 56 divided by 64 is actually smaller than 56 divided by 63. So therefore, the answer should be 8 over 9. So there you go. Next one. Monty and Tara buy pencils for school. Tara buys 2 times the number of pencils. Monty buys plus an additional 4 pencils. Let M be the number pencil Monty buys. So Monty buy M pencil. And Tara buys 2 times the number of Monty buys. So which is, so 2 times M. And additional 4 pencils. So we add 4. So that is 4 Tara. So therefore, we have to pick the right expressions. So we have 2 times M. So this is 4 times M is wrong. This is m divided by 2 is wrong. M divided by 4 is wrong. So the answer is 4 times m and add 4. So we can put brackets like this as well. So it's exactly the same. So therefore, the answer should be this one here. So there you go. Next one. A fair $1 coin and a fair $2 coin are tossed at the same time. What is the probability that both coins will show tails? So first of all, for a dollar, okay, the probability of getting a tail is a half because we only have head or tails, right? And for $2 coin, so we have a half as well for the probability. So therefore, if we times together, so it's a half times a half, which give me a quarter, because 1 times 1 is 1 and 2 times 2 is 4. So that should be here. Otherwise, you can also draw a tree diagram. So we have a tree diagram here. We, for the a dollar coin, we either have a head or a tail. And then for $2 coin, so you have a head or a tail. That is for $2 coin. And then this is for $2 coin as well, a head or a tail. So there you go. So to get two tail, so we have a tail and a tail. So that is one. So that is tail, tail here. That's what we want. And this branch here we have tail and head. And this branch here we have head and tail. And this branch here we have head, head. So therefore we have only one out of four. So therefore the probability is 1/4. Next one. Myra draws a scale map of Australia on the coordinate grid. She knows that the actual distance between Perth and Sydney is 3,294 kilometers. Which scale should Myra use for her map? So first of all, we know the distance is this. So that is 3,294 kilometers. That is from Perth to Sydney. So we need to work out the scale. So one of these is equal to how many kilometers? So first of all, we need to count. So from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 of them. And we have a little bit of this and a little bit of distance of that. So we roughly make it 8. So that is 8 of them. Otherwise, you can also use this coordinate here for the x coordinate. So from 1.3 to 9.2. So to find the distance, which is go 9.2 minus 1.3. So you should get 7.9. So we can just roughly 8, okay, 8 grid. So we just go, get and check. So if we go 8 times 78 kilometers, is no way near 3,294 kilometers. So this is wrong. And the second one, but let's try this one first because it's easier, okay? So we have 5,000 times 8. So 5 times 8 is 40. And we add that to 0, 1, 2. So that is 4,000 kilometers. A bit too much, okay? Compared to 3,294. So we try 400 kilometers. So now we have 4 times 8. So 4 times 8 is 32. So that add another 2, 0. So 32 kilometers. So that is very close. And if we use 262 times 8, so of course it's a lot less than 3,000. So therefore the answer is this 400 kilometers. That's all you need to do. Last one. This triangle is across the dotted line and then rotate clockwise. So clockwise is gone this way. So first of all, let me just draw this diagram first because about the dotted line. So it's just roughly, okay? So it's like this. It's like this. So now it's rotate. So if it rotate, so 90 degrees is here. Something like that, okay? Because it rotate. So therefore, the shape should be this one here, C. So there you go. And thank you so much for watching. Bye.